course, parents can book you, and that's what happened. But, like, throughout the week. But I was, like, I was bummed out on Monday. So don't be bummed out if you're doing this and, like, you don't get 500 bookings overnight, because they don't always happen overnight. Sometimes the parents don't book during the booking frenzy. They book when it's convenient for them throughout the week. So, yeah, after, like, the day had gone on and I went in and, like, I looked at my schedule, I felt better because I realized that I had 29 classes booked for that week. My goal is 30 a week. That's what I would like to teach. And now I'm up to 33 for that week as of right now. So, of course, parents can continue to book me, and they can continue to cancel. So, I mean, like, a lot of the times I'll get bookings and they'll immediately, it'll say, been booked for your 7 o'clock class, and it'll say you've been canceled, and then it'll say you've been booked again. So it's like parents are going back and forth and booking you and canceling, and, you know, trying to find the best fit for their kid. So that was Monday. Tuesday I taught 7 classes back to back. That was the first time that I had done that many classes back to back. It was crazy, but it was so fun. The time goes by so fast because you're just not, I don't know, it's like it's not a job. It's so fun to, like, see these kids and, you know, get updates on them and what they're doing and how they're learning. And so it's really fun. It's not like it, I haven't woken up in the morning and been like, oh my gosh, I don't want to do this. Every morning I wake up and I'm like, I get to go to China and see some kids. It's so cool. So let's see, I'm reading my notes down here. I printed out these lesson planner sheets, which that's what I mentioned before, was that I wanted to take some more, like, detailed notes about the students and how they're doing in the units and the lessons that you're teaching. So I printed these out. It was just like a free thing on Teachers Pay Teachers, and it fits 4 things on 1 sheet of paper. So I just, like, made a bunch of copies and have a folder of them. And so before my classes, I go in and, like, for my prep, I'll go in and write all the information up here at the top. So, like, the date, the time of the class, what lesson you're teaching, whether it's a major course. I think that's what NC stands for, major course, or a trial class, which I'm not certified to teach trials, so that doesn't apply to me. But, and then the student's name, their age, and whether they're a boy or a girl. And then that way you have all that information, and I've been putting a star next to their name if they're a student that I've had before, so that, you know, when they come up on my screen, I'm not like, hi, who are you? You know, I can kind of say, oh, hey, Tony, like, I've seen them before, and they recognize that I remember them. So there's that, and then it just has a spot for, like, lesson planning. So I write down, like, I go through the PowerPoint, and then I go through my thing. So I pull, like, flashcards that I need for that lesson, or, like, props that I need, and I have, like, a basket on the floor, and I just put all of that stuff in there. And then that way, for every lesson, I can just, it's easily accessible. I have it all ready instead of kind of spread out everywhere. So that's what I do there. And then it also has boxes. It's got 5 different boxes. One box says needs to work on, pronunciation practice, strengths and motivations, notes, and then target vocab and sentences. I don't really use the target vocab and sentences box just because that's already on the screen for you. Like, I don't feel the need to write it down when it's there for me. But I do use the needs to work on, pronunciation practice, strengths and motivations, and the notes section. So as I'm going through, I can jot, like, if they mispronounce September, I can put pronunciation practice. I can just write September, and then when I'm going back and doing my feedback, I can look and remember that, oh, this kid needed to practice this word. Because not yet anyway, I can't do my feedback in between classes. You literally have 5, I normally have less than 5, because I go over the 25 minute timestamp. Like, I'll go to 27 minutes, and then that leaves me not a lot of time to, like, clean up what I had, redo my reward, pull out my new props, and, like, start the class on time. So I just can't do my feedback in between classes yet. That just is not happening. So this is good to have so that when I do go back at the end of my classes, I can remember what happened during the class and what I need to put in on their feedback. So these have been very helpful. Wednesday was a rough day. I don't remember how many classes I had that day, but it was rough. It was just like the kids did not want to learn that day. They were just really struggling. And when they're struggling, I'm struggling. Like, I want them to want to learn. And so it was tough. I had one student who cried at the end of the lesson. He was just having a really hard time. He wasn't speaking. So normally what VIPKid wants is for you to talk 50% of the time and for the student to talk 50% of the time. So you say something, they say something. You say something, they say something. And he just wasn't having it. He didn't want to speak. He was upset. It was late. It was a 9:30 a.m. class. And so that's 9:30 p.m. in China. So I'm sure he was exhausted and he was just not feeling it. So I was trying to go through it. I kept telling him, you know, he was doing a great job. And then at the end, he was just crying and it was so sad. But I gave him all of his stars and that seemed to make him happy. Speaking of the stars, that was on my notes I took for like days. Thursday and Friday were fine. I have a regular student who is so sweet who I have on Friday and Saturday nights. So that's really exciting that I have like this regular student. He sent me a little like card that they have on the website, you know, saying, I love spending time with you. I can't wait to see you in class again. So it was really sweet. And I think on my last video, actually, I might have it in my notes right here. Let's flip back and see what it says. Yes, more reward systems. That was in my notes last time. I got these lovely Find a Star reward systems off of Teachers Pay Teachers. It was like $5, I think, for 40 different boards. And so what this is just, I have all my numbers here because I had pulled them off in my last class. I just taught 5 classes, by the way. It's very late. Very late. It's almost midnight. It's not that late. But I need to go to bed, but I wanted to film this. So anyway, I just finished teaching my last class, so this is all like taken down, but these just have magnets on the back, and you cover all of your pictures up like this, and these all have numbers on them, and the kids are supposed to guess the numbers, or like they pick a number, and then you pull it off, and if it has a star behind it, you're like, oh, good job, you get a star, and you can give them a star in their program, and if not, then I just, you know, it's vocab, so I mean, like, whale and shark. This one was kind of tough, though. I had, like, anemone. That was hard for some of the kids to say. They were all saying it, but it was hard to get out. I had one younger kid tonight. He was 5, and I just said ocean, because they can hardly see this anyway. So I was just like, ocean. I was like, ocean. So it worked out. But yeah, this is really cool. So what I'm going to do is have one of these every week and just use it for all of my students, and then that way I know I'm not repeating the same reward system with kids, because I had my fish reward system that was up here. I don't remember if I talked about it last time, but it was just like, I stuck a fish up there. I was like, oh, you get a fish, and they liked it, but it's not Find a Star. The kids love Find a Star because it's a star and it's something interactive with their program, and so they can physically see it on their screen. When they win a star, they get it on their screen. So they really like that. And I only printed out 20 of them and laminated them because I didn't really think I needed all 40 of them right now. So this was as much as I got through. But they have all different kinds. You know, it just helps build different like vocabulary words. So it's, you know, extending their knowledge of all these different things. Farm animals, wild animals. This is all toads and dogs and stuff. I don't really get that one, but like some fall and Christmas ones, winter. I'm very excited about these. It was a hit. I was kind of nervous because I had never used one before, but since I have, Wong is the student's name, who's the regular student that I've been having, and I figured I would try it with him because he's older and can kind of understand what I'm saying when I speak in like a full sentence, and he really liked this, and even some of the younger ones that I had, like I was saying, the five-year-old today, and he got so excited when a star popped up, and he actually didn't say the numbers. I don't know, this is hard for them to see, so what I'm thinking about doing is getting a cookie sheet and having it stuck to the cookie sheet, and then that way I can put it closer and they can pick, but for now this is what I have. But anyway, the younger one was just saying the color, so he'd be like red, and I would know to pull number one. So really it can work either way, like with the older kids they can pick a number and then the younger kids can just say the color. So that was pretty cool that it, you know, you can use it for a range of ages and levels, not just, you know, the older kids or the younger kids. So yeah. Some stats here. I opened up 48 slots for this week, the 18th through the 24th, and I booked 35. To all of those, I think I had one student no-show, but other than that, everybody showed up. And then I have two classes tomorrow, which I'm including in this count, so I'm assuming that they will be there. I will be there, so I will get paid whether they show up or not. So yeah, I thought that was pretty good. That means only 13 of my slots did not get booked, which is pretty awesome. I'm pretty happy with that. So, to wrap it up, I wrote down two goals that I wanted to reach. I don't know if I'll reach these by my next video, which will be next Saturday evening. But I want to get my advanced TESOL certification. So I have the foundational TESOL certification that was like required to teach VIPKid. And I thought that was really cool that you could get TESOL certified through VIPKid. So I did the foundational one, and the advanced one is available to me. I just haven't gone in and done it yet. So that is something that I would like to do. And also the phonics certification, which I think is really cool. I just love VIPKid because most of it, I mean, it is. It's phonics and it's math, which are the two things that I loved teaching phonics. Like when I was working in different classrooms and stuff, that was what I enjoyed doing the most was phonics and math. Math, those were my favorite courses in college, were my elementary math courses. I loved taking those and teaching math. And even though this is not, you know, Common Core mathematics, it's, you know, how many apples are there? You know, and there's five apples and they're just counting, but still, it's really fun. So anyway, the phonics certification and the advanced TESOL certification are the next